Hello everyone! This video will be an update on my M104 turbo build. At the moment I'm trying to fit the 6-speed manual gearbox into the chassis of the 202, and that's what I want to show you in this video. So all changes you need to do to the chassis and the shifter linkage and so on to fit this gearbox into your C-Class. First of all, you need to choose the right gearbox mounting. So originally this gearbox comes with this kind of mounting piece because it's a later generation. Those were mounted, or those were in the 203 models. Then in the 202 chassis you got two of those metal pieces for gearbox mounting. This one is for the automatic gearboxes. It moves the mounting point a little bit more in the back, and this one is for the manual gearboxes where the mounting point is a little bit more in the front. And this is the original mounting piece for the gearboxes in the 202. What I did, I chose this one because I used this already in my diesel racer, so this one goes well with the newer gearbox, with the later gearboxes. And then also this original mounting point from the 202. So this sits like this, and you need to modify this a little bit to fit to the newer gearboxes, because the whole distance here is different. Maybe we can see it here. Get rid of the screws. So it's maybe good to see. So those points are a little bit more close to each other. And also there's a kind of step here where the rubber starts. So you need to grind down this step a little bit also on the other side, and then grind the holes a little bit more to the inside so this fits to the newer gearbox. I already did this, I will show you on the gearbox itself. So here we see the gearbox underneath the car, and with this mounting point it's hard to see the grinding, but maybe here. Maybe see where I grinded this edge of the mounting piece a little bit more down, so it fits in between those aluminium pieces. So here, and I did the same for the holes, and this fits very well. Then for the metal holder, will fit here, but in this case, in combination with the M104 engine, you can't use the original points. If you use this gearbox on an OM605, you actually can use the original threads here in the chassis to fit this metal holder. But with the M104, the gearbox moves a little bit more in the back, so those original threads don't fit anymore. That's why I drilled some holes here and prepared those points for some nut rivets. I'm not sure if this is the right word, but some threads you can rivet inside of here. And then this piece will fit perfectly on this mount. This, and on the other side also like this, and this is already the right height of the gearbox, how it will sit underneath the car. The metal piece itself has to be modified a little bit, so those holes here for the mounting piece have to be widened a little bit in one direction so you can move it in the right position. But that's all. Other than that, this piece stays original. Another thing you need to do to fit this gearbox underneath the 202 is to make space, because the gearbox tunnel of the 202 is a little bit too small actually to fit this gearbox. You need to push the sheet metal a little bit out of the way. You can do this by, I don't know, use the hammer and find the right spot where to make space and then go with the hammer on this area. Or like I did it, I put a piece on top of the gearbox. So I made some metal base, some wood on top. This is squeezed pretty bad from the force, but I put this on top like this, on top of those this fork here, and then pushed the whole car up with the jack. There needs to be weight in the front, so this only works of course when the engine is in the car, but then it is possible to squeeze or push the metal out of the way of the gearbox tunnel to have enough space. I'm not sure if this is good to see, but this is the real position now for the gearbox, and I will have space here around, let's say, 8 millimeters, 8 or 9 millimeters on top of those of this fork to the sheet metal of the gearbox tunnel. And this should be enough space, because in this mounting piece you have less than 4 millimeter movement. It allows less than 4 millimeter movement of the gearbox to the top, so there should never be a situation where the gearbox hits the gearbox tunnel with this element here. The second big change needs to be done on the shifter linkage. What you see here is the disassembled shifter linkage, which originally comes with the gearbox, so the 716.654, when it is mounted into the 203 model. I got the connection here from the shifter rod to the gearbox, so this piece gets to the gearbox, this one to the shifter rod, so like this, and this sits inside of this housing, and there's some plastic covers and stuff like that. But this is the main centerpiece, so this gets mounted to the gearbox here with a pin, and then this piece here needs to fit the hole in the gearbox tunnel, which goes to the inside. So the shifter rod is here, and this needs to have the right length. And as you can see, I cut it already because I need to make it shorter, because in this length it wouldn't fit, and I need to remove around 7 centimeters. So my plan is here, make a cut, also make a cut in this area, so to move 7 centimeters out of this linkage, and then put them back together with some kind of metal pieces. You can put screws here on the side, maybe also here, and make it rigid, and then screw it back together on this position. So it will actually look like this, and then it should have the right length to go underneath the car. Then the other change you need to do is to make the opening bigger where the shifter comes through the gearbox tunnel. So this is what I need to show you inside of the car. That's the original hole here. And this is the frame which gets mounted on the gearbox tunnel. So my plan is to mount it like this. I need to cut out a little bit of the cable tray here, and also a little bit of the carpet, so there will be some cutout like this, and here maybe a small cutout, and then I can mount this to this area, and we'll cut out the gearbox tunnel according to this shape of the frame, and then everything should be prepared to mount the shifter linkage to this gearbox tunnel. There is the shifter linkage frame now. I put it together in the right length. You see, I used some aluminium sheet metal and put some rivets inside. So this is very strong now. and those are the pieces I cut out, so it's around 7 centimeters, and also I had to increase this angle a little bit. So normally it would be in a more straight shape, but this angle has to be a little bit more to fit the gearbox tunnel perfectly. And I will show you now how it fits under the car. So the test fit looks good. This is just mounted without the foam, because I need to wait until the paint is dried. But this is how the shifter frame sits in the cutout. And I will also give you the look from top now. So, here you see the top view. Oh, the lighting is not so good. Like this, you can see how it sits inside of there. It looks like it is a little bit to the right, but it fits the shape of the foam. You can see here it's very thin, and here it's a little bit thicker. So that's how the shifter frame should sit. It's in the perfect position. And after the paint is dried, I will assemble it, and then I can start cutting the shifter linkage itself, so the rod which goes from the shifter knob to the gearbox. While finishing the shifter rod, I also made a short shifting upgrade, which is very easy to do with this type of shifter linkage. You can see the main rod here, which comes through and is has a ball bearing here, and the ball itself is just put in place by two pins. So one pin on the bottom, you can see it maybe here. There's the pin holding a washer, and then there's the ball, and same is on top. And I just moved the holes for the pins 1 centimeter to the top, so this part of the shifter reaches out more to the bottom, and with that you get a short shifting upgrade. And what I also did, I moved this piece the same distance, so also 1 centimeter up, so all on top has the right position like it is original. Here you see the prepared modification of the connecting rod for the shifter linkage. So I try to also remove 7 centimeters. It's exactly 7.2 centimeters. And now I will weld those pieces together and then test fit and see if this is already the perfect solution. I now got the perfect shape and length of the connecting rod for the shifter linkage. I needed to adjust the angle a little bit on the area of cutting, because you need a good compromise between space to the gearbox tunnel and to the prop shaft. It's a very tight space, so you have to play around a little bit to get even spacings to both elements. And I will assemble it now and then show you how tight it fits inside the 202. The shifter linkage is fully assembled now. Because I made the short shift upgrade, this joint moves down, so you can't put the normal cover in place, the original cover at this area. So I just used an old rubber piece from a CV joint to seal this, so there's no possibility for the dust to go on the ball joint. And now it is almost done. I will fit now the prop shaft, and then we can have a last look on the spacing. It's very tight, especially here in this area from the connecting rod to the gearbox tunnel, and also in this area to the prop shaft. What you also should do is to grind out this area a few millimeters, so there's more space to the prop shaft. But that's it, and I will show you from top now how it shifts.
So one last view from underneath. Everything is in place now. The connecting rod has approximately 6 to 7 millimeters space to the prop shaft. Everything fits and I'm pretty happy with how it worked out. So now you know what to change to fit the newer gearboxes into your 202.
Thanks everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and there was some valuable information for you. If you want to support the channel, like and subscribe, I would appreciate it. And see you in the next video.